Hi, hello. Since this is the last day that of this week, which is my red week, so using paint that's red, and actually I haven't done an awful lot else aside from pick some raspberries and eat raspberry jam regarding red. But anyway, so I'm going to do a little bit more to this portrait. I thought I'd just carry it on. Sometimes it's the simplest thing to do, is just work with what's still on the table, you know, or on the easel, whatever, rather than have to make a decision every day about what to do, you know. So here we go. And because you're close enough to me here, I reckon I'm not going to need to find the microphone. I suppose I might do something on the other side of my face. Sorry guys, I'm blocking my vision with the iPad. Okay, that's all right-ish, I think. Yeah, I like these colours. That are on the palette here, you know. Okay. There's quinacridone red and opera rose and Jackson's red, crimson, alizarin crimson. So I'll just carry on with what's here and move down my face a wee bit maybe. And I'm working like yesterday, still on the Yupo paper. Which has got a shiny hint to it. I seem to have made myself a little bit smaller than life size. Almost a resistance from the brush without even touching the paint. You see that? It kind of pushes it away. Anyway, I don't know why that's happening. Okay, so as I'm painting my mouth, I won't be talking much. I'm not positive of the distances here, so I'll just let myself still be deciding where exactly chin is located. But I can mark down, I think, from the nose into the area of the mouth. And this orange is pearl orange. Got it for a flower painting workshop I was teaching, actually, down in London then. Maybe in May it was. And I've since injected it into some portraits and things. It was really to try and explain the brightness of an orange gerbera that I had in the mix for that workshop. Because sometimes I think purples and oranges are hard to make as vibrant as they are in flowers by mixing paint. So something in the mouth, maybe I'll find something for my upper lip there. Or the line dividing the lips. Seems to be a mix of lots of reds I'm using here. If you're interested to join an online watercolour course, I'm running one from the 14th of October, and there's, I think, 3 places left in that. Yeah, I think my jaw will come up a wee bit.
This is in the walk now. And just do something more to complete the lips a wee bit more. Maybe a shadow here or something. And then I can maybe carry on tomorrow, even although I'll have changed colour. I don't know what colour it is that I'm starting this week with. That's the colour for next week, I mean. All right, I'm going to stop there and maybe carry on with it tomorrow. So that's what happened today. A wee bit more nose and mouth. I don't know if I'll be filling in some of that later, but for now it's fine anyway. Okay, oh, I'm sorry. So, see you tomorrow. Thanks for joining me. Bye.